Now, next point is, what is the procedure for making an application under this Act and who can make it? The senior citizen themselves can make an application, or any voluntary organization can make it? Because many a times it has been seen that senior citizens are not in that position to come out of their home and address the matter to investigating agency or to court. So any NGO, any voluntary organization can come forward and address that dispute, address that issue before the court. And court can itself take the suo motu action if anything comes to his knowledge of its own. So senior citizen, any voluntary organization and court on its own can cognizance of the matters falling under this Act. Procedure provided under this Act is very simple. Once the application is made to the tribunal constituted under this Act, then they are required to dispose of the matter within 90 days from the date of the notice served to the opposite party. This procedure is not very technical, so there is no requirement of hiring the advocate. At the same time, looking into the position of the senior citizen, the maintenance officer is always there to help them in their paperwork, in assisting them to represent their case before the tribunal. The maintenance which can be provided under this Act cannot be more than 10,000 rupees. The interesting and the most important feature of this Act is, before settling the dispute on the merit of the case, the tribunal always encourages the party to adopt the means of conciliation. Whenever any matter is brought before it, they try the means of conciliation for settling the dispute, because it is understood that if a conflict has been disposed of by conciliation, then it maintains the amicable relation between the parties. Whereas, sometime in one-sided decision, the relationship between the parties gets spoiled forever. As even the legislation recognizes the importance of institution of families and the importance of care of family in old age, that's why conciliation has been recognized as a means of dissolution of dispute at the first instance. If conciliation fails, then court can adjudicate the matter on the merit of the case. This Act also gives direction to the state for the establishment of old age homes. It says that it is the duty of each state, and each state should try to establish old age homes with at least capacity of 150 people. Provision for medical care of senior citizen. This Act also provides for medical facilities for senior citizen. It provides that it is the duty. It is required from all the government hospitals and also from all the hospital which have received some grant from the center or the state to provide special facilities to senior citizen. Some of such special facilities are separate queues for senior citizen, treatment of chronic diseases which are common in old age home, and setting up of research center for doing further research in those diseases which are more common in old age homes. This Act also provides for protection of property of senior citizen. It says, if a senior citizen has transferred his property with the condition to the transferee that the person to whom they have transferred the property would take care of them in old age, and if that person who has taken the property of the senior citizen doesn't take care of them, then they have every right to approach the tribunal and get the property transferred back to them. So now there are no chance of benefit for those people who think that by mischief, by undue influence, they can get the property transferred from the senior citizen on a promise that they will take care of them in old age home, and after that throw them out of their home or forcing them to live in a miserable condition. If the senior citizen is not satisfied with the treatment and care provided by the transferee, then they can get the transfer cancelled and they can take back the property which they have transferred on a condition of care and protection to that person. Offences and procedure of trial. If any person who has responsibility to take care of a senior citizen abandons him with an intention to leave him forever, it's an cognizable offence, and that person will be punished with 5,000 rupees or an imprisonment of 3 months or both. Various initiatives have been taken up by ministries and the central government. Ministry of Railway has provided certain special rights to senior citizen, like separate ticket counters at the booking counter, provision for lower berth. If senior citizen apply for booking of a ticket, then he'll be given preference in allotting lower berths, looking into his physical condition. At the same time, certain concessions are also provided to senior citizens, and it is also mandatory for every railway station to have wheelchair for senior citizen. Ministry of Health and Family Welfare also provides certain special provision for senior citizen, which are that if a person is suffering from any chronic disease for which he needs to take a medicine for a longer period of time, then he can take medicine for 3 months at a stretch. Such provision help him in taking his medicine regularly. Otherwise, he will have to come to the hospital again and again to take more medicine, as he can take medicine for 3 months at a stretch, so it will help him to take his medicine regularly. After the National Mental Health Program, the objective of this program is to work towards the need of those senior citizens who are suffering from Alzheimer, Parkinson's diseases, depression and other mental related problems. There are certain benefits which are provided to senior citizen regarding the banking transaction. If a senior citizen invests some money, deposits certain money in a saving account, then he is provided higher rate of interest. At the same time, his interest is exempted from the tax. In addition to that, if a senior citizen has deposited his amount for a fixed period of time and because of certain urgency like medical problem, he has to break his fixed deposit earlier, then the general penalty which is attached to everybody falling in this category is not imposed on the senior citizen. Ministry of Finance also provides certain exemption to the senior citizens. Department of Pension has also special provision of pension for the senior citizen. The Department of Pension has set up a pension portal from which the senior citizen can know the state of their pension, the amount of pension which is due to them, and if they have any grievance regarding the payment of pension, they can also address the grievance through this portal to the Department of Pension. Ministry of Civil Aviation also provides special concession in airfares to the people who are senior citizens. Ministry of Road Transport and Highways similarly provides special provision and special benefits and schemes for the senior citizen. It has provided reservation of 2 seats in all the government buses, and at the same time it provides fare concession to them. National Old Age Scheme provides for pension to all those people who are above 60 years of age and who are destitute, means who are not in a position to maintain themselves. An amount of 200 rupees is provided to them by the central government. This amount is in addition to the pension which they can claim from the state government as per the schemes of pension formulated by the state governments. To summarize, I would like to say that we have adequate provision for the protection of right of senior citizen. The need of the hour is the effective implementation of these provision, and that can be done only if senior citizen regain their faith in the justice delivery system. It is the time that they should be made aware of their rights, because if they are not aware of their rights, then the no question of raising their dispute and exercising of these available right comes. So first thing which needs to be done is to make the senior citizen aware of their rights, and second thing, to make them believe the justice delivery system is there to help them and protect them. The only thing required from their part is to cooperate with justice administration system and not to sit quietly, and come forward, raise their voice and get their dispute redressed with the court of justice. And this will actually discourage the wrongdoer against committing crime, because many a times it has been seen that when senior citizen doesn't raise their voice against the injustice, then the wrongdoers take them for granted, and they feel and believe that these senior citizens, as they are old and infirm, they will never come forward and make complaint against them. So it actually encourages them to do whatever they want to do and to violate their right easily and go away with it without attracting any penalty. We have adequate provision for the rights of senior citizen. The only thing which is required is the effective implementation of these provision. These provision can effectively be implemented if senior citizens are aware of their rights. So we need to work on this area. We need to make senior citizens aware of their rights. Second thing which we need to work on is to encourage senior citizen to cooperate with the justice delivery system and the investigating agency. If they start sharing the information which is required by the investigating agency and the court, then it would become easier for the court and the investigating agency to do justice with them. Thank you.